all of which is basically that.
Just a short-term rent and utility assistance program runs very much like LAMP. When clients may lose their job or have some sort of loss of income, if they're in jeopardy of losing their housing, they just come in and request assistance. They're on their own lease, the utilities are in their name, and if they qualify, then we help them to get their rent caught up or their utilities reconnected, what have you.
And the Lowndes County Board of Health does not lease or buy anything. Before our signing the lease at Waymark Oil on behalf of the Lowndes County Board of Health, which would make us the leasor, we at that point would have been liable. First thing that came up was that there was a fire report. Reports on the contained. Did not do any damage beyond the kitchen area, and no one was injured. Brought the question of liability, found out that the state is not necessarily the efforts of two liberal opinions to consider this a normal function of the Florida Road Company, including the lead lawyer for the DOAS. However, we did not realize that you could split them apart until we started looking into it. And I'm giving you background. I think everybody else here is in the background. You're not even very busy in your position. And if the liability became an issue here, I found out that the OIS, like we had, with the one other board in Atlanta, they were doing something that I opted not to pay. So as Jerry has worked extremely hard with the wish of this board, we terminated the part completely. We'll find out the part where we actually took over the mortgage or the lease property. The hypo component, the little secure issue here, the county accepted $500,000 from HUD 10 years ago, obligated themselves through us for us to do hop work there. They gave us $500,000 for 10, but we had to rent hop work. This county did for 10 years. Had we completely terminated the program, the county would be possibly owed HUD back $500,000 over the road. We were 10 years short of a 20-year obligation on the part of the county. The Board of Health did not sign that. County signed that. However, in terms of integrity, we had a pretty much, not each remember some of this. I went back out to Venice and it was a big packet I did for you. We didn't know Shelter Plus could be separated out, and I found out Shelter Plus had been taken on after Hopwood existed. Hopwood is basically a money transfer. Don't take on any legal obligation or rent. Or in this other situation we were. And Shelter Plus, we were not really clear. They could be separated out. And John, the chief person, John Bassett, at the state level, actually came down, met with us, and even then didn't make it clear to me that either was all or none. But we found out after the board decided, said this, they wanted to terminate by September 30th of this year. Well, the whole thing could be separated out. We didn't have to do that. So we are maintaining the HOPA component, the Shelter Plus component, which is all liability. We couldn't even get private liability to cover us recently. We now, as of September 30th, basically will only owe $530 for all these leases that we were obligated to for up to 12 months. Landlords have worked with Jerry. Jerry has worked very hard at taking care of this. On the other hand, we did not want the board members to be liable for anything that we found out that they really were liable for. And that, as of September 30th, will have been done at the direction of the board and the chairman of the board. And to figure in, we're sort of at where we're going to be. Help them for 10 more years. The county stay in that building, rent that property for 10 more years. That was HUD's fine, John Bassett was HUD in Atlanta's fine, and I just been most compassionate that could be done. We're saying that the pipes are taken care of, and the board no longer cares about them. And have that, the question came up.